Welcome to Materials. I'm joined by Mohammad Choucair. Mohammad, nice to see you.
Good to be here. Thank you.
Look, big deal that you've announced today with IBM. Tell us more about this agreement.
So we've signed a quantum computing agreement with IBM, and this is absolutely fantastic news for Archer. It's been a long time in the making, and you know, it's testament to the hard work that we've been doing for the last 12 months. And essentially, you know, if we cut to the end, what it means is that we'll be able to really fast-track the development of our quantum computing chip.
Tell me more about the chip itself. What makes it different to other chips?
So the one unique thing about the 1-2-CQ quantum computing chip is that it has the potential to be used onboard modern electronic devices at room temperature. So if you could imagine when we are successful, that this could enable the widespread use of quantum computing powered devices.
Can you give us some, without being too technical, give us some applications as to how this might be used?
So quantum computing is set to really impact all sectors that rely on an ever increasing amount of computational power. But very early on now in the development of quantum computers, a lot of the big players and indeed within the quantum economy, the applications can be, you know, far-ranging. For example, artificial intelligence, drug design and discovery, medical diagnostics, you know, it's absolutely phenomenal. And, you know, let's not forget financial services.
Of course. How far advanced is the development of the chip?
So we're in a very early stage of development. However, we've made great strides over the last year. And of course, the technology didn't just start 1 year ago. It is built off, you know, a very long time, a very decent effort when it comes to R&D. The IP was exclusively licensed from the University of Sydney and EPFL in Switzerland.
So what would be your longer term? What are the plans here? To sell the chip and then sub-license the IP around it. Is that right?
Yeah, I mean, we're not trying to reinvent the wheel when it comes to business models. And essentially, we would apply a well-known business model in the semiconductor and computing industries. And that's to either sub-license aspects of the development of the chip and build it and sell it itself.
So this clearly is it's a big endorsement for a relatively young company.
So we are, you know, small. We have been listed on the ASX since 2007. We are well and truly a materials technology company. But within the, you know, quantum economy, I would say in the broader computing industry, one of the hallmarks of success is that the industry itself was built off, you know, one or two very clever people leading a company all the way through to success. And indeed, you know, today what we see is the industry still reliant on those smaller players with very disruptive, innovative solutions, like the 1-2-CQ chip.
Are there many other Australian companies part of this IBM Q network or community?
It's nice that you've raised it, actually. We are the first Australian company that's building a quantum processor chip to join the IBM Q network. So it's absolutely wonderful, and I'm absolutely very proud of the achievement of the team at Archer.
And so you should be. A big day for you. Look, lovely to see you, Mohammad. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.